Welcome to Pathan sir chemistry class. We'll derive Schrodinger's wave equation, which is time independent. Okay. Now derivation of Schrodinger's wave equation depend upon two things. One is pure mathematical property of wave. Another is wave property of matter, that is de Broglie's equation. Okay. Now equation of wave in one dimension is given as d2 psi upon dx square is equals to minus 4 pi square divided by lambda square into psi. Say it is equation number 1. Now using same relationship, we can write same equation for 3 dimension. Okay, then this equation is given as d2 psi upon dx square plus d2 psi upon dy square plus d2 psi upon dz square is equals to minus 4 pi square divided by lambda square into psi as equation number 2. Okay, now here this d2 upon dx square plus d2 upon dy square and d2 upon dz square is called as Cartesian operator. Now replacing this Cartesian operator by Laplacian operator, we get, now Laplacian operator is del square, which is equals to d2 upon dx square plus d2 upon dy square plus d2 upon dz square. Therefore, this equation number 2 becomes del square psi is equals to minus 4 pi square divided by lambda square into psi. Say it as equation number 3, where this psi is amplitude. This psi is amplitude of matter wave. Okay, and this equation number 3 is a fundamental postulate. This is a fundamental postulate of Schrodinger's statement. Okay, now we'll introduce second point, that is wave property of matter into this equation. That is, we'll use lambda is equals to h upon mu into this equation. Therefore, substitute the value of this lambda, which is de Broglie's hypothesis. Now de Broglie's equation as lambda is equals to h upon mu into this equation, then it is del square psi is equals to minus 4 pi square divided by lambda square. So instead of lambda square, you will write h upon mu square. Then it becomes minus 4 pi square, it is h square upon m square u square, or the same equation del square psi is equals to this m square u square will go up, and it is minus 4 pi square m square u square divided by h square. Okay, don't forget this psi, and multiplied by psi. Okay, then now this, in this equation we need the value of u square. Okay, for that we have kinetic energy. Okay, kinetic energy is difference between total energy minus potential energy. Okay, say kinetic energy is half mu square. Total energy is denoted as capital E and potential as capital V. Then from this equation we have u square is equals to this 2 will go towards this side, it is 2 times E minus V, okay, divided by M. Okay, say it as this as equation number 4 and this one as equation number 5. So substitute the value of u square from equation number 5 into equation number 4. Therefore, from equation 4 and equation number 5 we get, okay, it is del square psi is equals to minus 4 pi square m square divided by h square. Instead of u square, now put the value of u square as 2 times e minus v divided by m. Okay, and psi as it is, this m square, this m cancelled. Okay, and this equation becomes del square psi is equals to minus 4 pi square m upon h square. Now see here, it is 4 into 2, 8. So instead of minus 4, we'll write 8. So it is minus 8 pi square m upon h square into e minus v into psi. And this take minus term towards this side. You can write del square psi plus 8 pi square m upon h square into e minus v into psi is equals to 0. This equation number 6 is nothing but Schrodinger's wave equation. And last, we'll replace this del square by Cartesian operator. Then this equation number 6 can be written as d2 psi upon dx square plus d2 psi upon dy square plus d2 psi upon dz square plus 8 pi square m upon h square into e minus v into psi is equals to 0. Say it as equation number 7. So these two, equation number 6 and equation number 7, are known as Schrodinger's wave equation. Schrodinger's wave equation, which are time independent. You can see that equation number 6 and 7 both don't contain time term. Okay, so if you like this, subscribe channel.